As the final day of the Senior One selection process unfolded, Brother Stephen Mogawo, the president of the Association of Secondary Schools Head Teachers Uganda, showed concern over the allegations that some schools do not attend the selection exercise.
People who claim that they are coming with lists from the ministry, Mama stopped that activity. Minister, if I'm telling a lie, you will correct me. But Mama was very clear. I was in front of her and she said, nobody should be taking lists to schools.
The Undersecretary of the Ministry of Education, Dr. Jane Egao, urged schools to put out their admission lists as soon as they're done with selection process, for the parents to know their stand as far as admissions are concerned. She also appealed to her teachers not to admit learners who do not qualify, emphasizing that they won't be registered at Senior 4. She, however, cautioned against imposing additional conditions such as interviews and stressed the importance of admitting students based on merit to maintain the integrity of the placement exercise.
We have heard of teachers who live here and then they first put the admission list in the box and parents keep coming and complaining. Please admit, please release those lists so that the parents can settle. Please also note that the placement exercise does not end here and today. Many parents will continue to come to the schools seeking for either special consideration or guidance. You may also need them to consider cases for replacement.
Some of the head teachers who participated in the selection exercise had this to say.
It's been very good, as you see. I've taken children from 9 aggregates to 28 aggregates, because this is a government school and we are supposed to take all the children.
The rural schools, our applicants, most of the choices made are from the primary schools that neighbor the secondary school within their area. Okay? So there isn't that much competition, because for them they know where they are going, so they make their choices from an informed position. It is these parents who are living in the urban areas that they have now to choose which school to take their child to.
You have picked the best students on merit. Why do I say this? As government and as a ministry, we do not expect again you to ask these students or these pupils to pay money to get those admissions.
Peter Ogwang, the State Minister for Sports, appealed to head teachers to give learners opportunities to participate in sports.
Use of overaged or none students to participate in school championship competition. I want to remind you, the time I addressed you last year, I didn't have the law. But today, for the record, you, the head teacher, you will be punished as you, for accepting to use a kid or a player or a student who is not, first of all, studying in that school.
He, however, encouraged inclusive education and highlighted the importance of greening schools for climate promotion, and further called upon schools to instill and promote moral values.
I urge you, school administrators, to play a leading role by putting in place measures to combat this threat. We have an opportunity to empower our young people and lay a strong foundation for exemplary, God-fearing citizens who will become ambassadors of faith, protect our values, and transform our communities.
Reports compiled by Sharon Navasidie for the news.